yesterday your teachers asked for 3 months. Ma'am, in which the Duke enters, and he is just he is just talking to Shylock to ma'am to take the double money which he has taken from Shylock, and not to take the 1 pound of flesh. But Shylock is expressing his views that he want to take that his main motive is to take revenge from Antonio, as he had insulted him so much. Ma'am, then Bassanio enters.
Okay.
Ma'am, then again he also requested Shylock not to hurt Antonio and not to take the 1 pound of flesh from his body. And but Shylock still that Bassanio can talk any further anything on another topic, but not on this topic, as he as Antonio is responsible for the things that he does, and he should and Shylock will take 1 pound on flesh on any cost, as he has taken the oath.
Right. So what happens here? Now we see there's a courtroom, and in this courtroom, what is going on? Here there is a judge, the Duke, who is going to take, who will be looking after the case, and he will give the judgment related to the matters that will be proceeded in the court. And here Shylock, just a minute. Excuse me. So here Shylock, Antonio, Bassanio, all these people are there. And now Antonio has just thanked the Duke, saying first of all the Duke is sorry to Antonio for calling him there for such a matter, and he says that he tried to persuade the Jew, but the Jew did not agree to anything. And Antonio says that I know everything, that you tried your level best to talk to the Duke, but he's a very cruel man, he's not listening to anything. Everybody in the courtroom is trying to persuade, everybody is trying to insist that he can take the money, the double money, the triple money, but Shylock is bent upon his bond, and he's saying that only his bond will speak and nothing else will speak, right? And he's also saying that if the Duke doesn't give the proper judgment, then the entire city will be in danger. How will it be in danger? Because if papers, legalities are not looked after and things are not fulfilled, then obviously nobody will believe anybody else, no legalities will be believed, and people will start taking their own judgments. Okay, so and he's everybody is trying to tell him that he should not do this, but he is bent upon taking the revenge. Okay, and now let's see what happens the next. Duke, upon my part, which page number? My book is a little different.
So 115.
Right. So now the Duke, upon my power, I may dismiss this court unless Valerio, a learned doctor whom I have sent for the determine this, for to determine this, come here today. So the Duke is saying that I have this power, I can adjourn the court, I can postpone the proceedings, I'm waiting for Dr. Valerio, whom I have called to look upon the matter. Silerio, my lord, here stays without a messenger with letters from the doctor, new come from Padua. So he's saying, Silerio told the Duke that there is some person, some lawyer who is standing out from Padua. I have never seen him before. He's some new person who has come from Padua, and he's having some letters in his hand. Duke, bring us the letters. Call the messenger. Bassanio, good cheer, Antonio. What man courage yet? The Jew shall have my flesh, blood, bones, and all. Thou shalt lose for me one drop of blood. So the Duke is saying that call the messenger inside and bring the letters. And then Bassanio is saying, he's now talking to Antonio, and he's saying, cheer up, Antonio, don't feel sad, be brave, okay? We will not let Bassanio take your blood, your flesh, your bones, nothing. And before that, I will not even let him take one drop of blood from your body. Before that, he will have to, he will have to face me. Don't worry, you will be fine. Shylock takes out a knife from his girdle and begins to whet it. So Shylock takes out a knife and he starts sharpening it. Antonio, I am tainted wetter on the flock. Meetest for death, the weakest kind of fruit, drops earliest to the ground, and so let me. You cannot better on you than to live still and write my epitaph. So he's saying, I am like a sheep, sick sheep. So Antonio is saying, don't bother about me, Antonio. I am liable to death now. I have done something, now I will die. Don't worry about me. I am one of the weakest fruits. Down the weak fruits, they do not keep on, they fall down very soon. So he's saying, I am like a weak fruit and now I am about to fall down. My death was not certain. At this age I should have not died. I'm like a weak fruit and my death is soon because I'm a weak fruit. Okay, and he's saying, Bassanio, do anything. Don't try to give away your life for me. It is better for you to live and write about my story on my tombstone. Tombstone, in Christians, you might have seen when there is a grave, there is a stone put up. It grave, Kyopar, there is a name and date of birth and all those things, and some loved one also write their messages on that. Okay, so that is a tombstone. So he's saying that you should stay alive to write all that I have done on my tombstone. Otherwise, nobody I have who will do this for me. Enter Nerissa, dressed like a lawyer's clerk. So now Nerissa comes. She is dressed like a lawyer's assistant, a clerk. Duke, come you from Padua, from Valerio? So he is saying, you have come from Dr. Valerio. You have come from the Padua. Nerissa, boast from both. My lord, Valerio greets you, grace. So he's saying, greets your grace. So Nerissa bows down and she's saying that Valerio has sent you greetings. He has sent you good messages. Bassanio, why dost thou wet thy knife so earnestly? So Bassanio, I just told you that Shylock took out his knife and he was just trying to sharpen it. So Bassanio is saying, why are you trying to sharpen your knife so earnestly, so keenly? You are sharpening your knife. Why are you doing it, Shylock? Shylock, to cut the forefeature from the bankrupt there. So Shylock says, I am sharpening my knife so that I can cut 1 pound of flesh from the body of Antonio. He's clearly stating his intentions. He's saying that I am doing it so that I can cut 1 pound of flesh from his body. Gratiano, not on thy soul, but on thy soul, harsh Jew. Yeah, here now pun is being used, P-U-N, pun. Okay, pun is a figure of speech where one word has two meanings. You know all this figure of speech, no?
Yes.
Same word has two meanings. It is pronounced in the same manner, but the spelling and the meanings are different. Now, S-O-L-E, soul, is the shoe sole, and S-O-U-L is the soul inside us, right? So he's saying, not thy soul, but on thy soul, harsh Jew, thou makest thy knife keen, but no metal can, no, not the hangman's axe, bear half the keenness of thy sharp envy. Can no prayers pierce thee? So Gratiano is saying that you keep on sharpening your knife. You are a harsh person. Your soul is very harsh, not the soul, but your soul inside is very harsh. But do not worry. No metal can cut this hardness that you have inside. No metal can cut this harsh behavior that you have inside. Can no prayers go inside your heart? We are all praying to you. Are you not affected by any of the prayers that we are making in front of you? Shylock, no, none that thou hast wit enough to make. So Shylock is saying, no prayers are getting into my heart. Because you are not clever enough. Whatever cleverly you are showing, whatever you do, none of the prayers will be able to, pierce my heart. No prayers will go inside my heart, and I will not forgive this man. Gratiano, O be thou damned, inexorable dog, and for thy life justice be accused. Thou almost makest me waver in my faith to hold opinion with Pythagoras, that souls of animals infuse themselves into the trunks of men. Thy cherished spirit governed a wolf, who hanged for human slaughter, even from the gallows did his fell soul fleet, and whilst thou layest in thy unhollow hollow dam, infused itself in thee, for thy desires are wolfish, bloody, starved, and ravenous. So he's saying, Gratiano is saying, you are a dog, you are an obstinate dog, and no justice will be given to you, because this is not justice, okay? And you have always tried to make me doubtful of Christianity. Well, I am a Christian, and you have always, Shylock, as you all know, is a Jew, and Gratiano here is a Christian. So he's saying, you have always tried to infuse hatred for Christianity in me. You have always told me Pythagoras theories, like, and there are souls of animals which sometimes enter the body of the men, and you know, there are people who have animal souls inside them. Christians have animal soul inside them. Similarly, you have an animal soul inside them who is filled with so much hatred. Okay. And he's saying that even as he was hanged, there was a wolf who was hanged on the trees. He's saying his, you know, savage soul, his wild soul, it is there in your body, and your inclinations are wolf-like. Means you are a wolf. You are bloody, you are starved, and you are very dangerous. Okay? Shylock, till thou canst rail the seal from my bonds, thou but offendest thy lungs to speak so loud. Repair thy wit, good youth, you or it will fall to cureless ruin. I stand here for law. So Shylock, as you all know, is a very cruel man, and he's saying, you are actually wasting your words in front of me. You are bothering your lungs uselessly, and you should not do this. Try to cultivate a more furnished sense of humor. There should be a sense of humor in you. Whatever you are doing, you are breaking yourself. You are trying to persuade me. I will not be persuaded by anything. And here I am. I stand here for judgment. I claim judgment here. You will not be able to do anything. Duke, this letter from Valerio doth commend a young and learned doctor to our court. There is he. So now the Duke speaks in between, and he says that according to the letter, there is a young man, young lawyer, who has come to fight this case. Where is that young man? Till now only Nerissa has entered. Till now Portia has not entered. The lawyer has not entered. Only the assistant has entered with the letters. So the Duke is saying that according to this letter, there is a learned lawyer who was supposed to be here. Where is that lawyer? Okay. Nerissa, he attendeth here hard by to know your answer, whether you'll admit him. So Nerissa is saying he is present here and he is waiting for your answer, if you will allow him to fight the case or not. Duke, with all my heart, some three or four of you go give him courteous conduct to this place. Meantime, the court shall hear Valerio's letter. So Duke says that I will welcome this man with all my heart. He sends three or four people. He says, you all go and call him and give him a warm welcome. Until then, by the time he comes, let's read what is written in Valerio's letter. And then the letter which Valerio has sent is read out loud. Okay. Clerk, your grace shall understand that at the receipt of your letter, I am very sick. But in the instant that your messenger came in loving visitation, was with me a young doctor of Rome. His name is Balthazar. So now Dr. Valerio's letter is read, and in the letter it is written that your grace shall understand that, Duke, you should understand that when you sent me this letter, I was really sick. But instantly, at that very moment, I had a person with me whose name is Dr. Balthazar. He's from Rome. He's a very learned man, and he's from Rome. I acquainted him with the cause in the controversy between the Jew and Antonio, the merchant. We turned over many books together. He's furnished with my opinion, with which bettered with his own learning, his greatness, whereof I cannot enough commend, comes with him at my inopportunity to fill up your grace's request in my stead. So he's saying he's a very learned man. I told him everything about the, you know, controversy that is going on between Antonio and Shylock. And we read out a lot of books and many things we tried to find out. And he also supports my opinion that Antonio is innocent. And he is coming there in order to protect him. And I am very sorry that I could not be present on your request. I beseech you, let his lack of years be no impediment to let him lack a reverent estimation, for I never knew so young a body with so old a head. So he's saying that I request you to forget one thing that he's not very experienced. His years of working are not much. He's new in this field, but still he has a very experienced mind. His young body has a very old mind, very experienced mind. Old are considered to be experienced, right? I leave him to your gracious acceptance, whose trial shall better publish his commendation. Sorry. So he's saying that I am sending you this man so that you can, this will show up his praises even better. Means he's saying that when he comes there, you will, and when you listen to him, give him a chance, listen to him, and he will praise him. Any problem, children?
No, ma'am.
Can you just read out till here so that if you have any issues, you can ask? This is quite a long scene, so I want you all to read in between so that if you face any problems, you can ask. Should be clear to you all. Reading, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Any problem? Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Any problem?
No, ma'am.
Shall we proceed?
Yes.
Okay. Duke, you hear the learned Valerio, what he writes, and here I take it is the doctor come. So Duke tells everybody, you all heard what Dr. Valerio has written, and here is the doctor, here is the lawyer. Doctor means the lawyer we are talking about. Here is the doctor who is coming to fight for Antonio. Enter Portia dressed like a doctor of laws. So here doctor means the doctor of laws, means a lawyer, right? So Portia enters dressed like a lawyer, okay? me your hand. Come, you from old Valerio. So the Duke says, give me your hand. He tries to shake hands with Dr. Balthazar, that is Portia. And he asks, Dr. Valerio has sent you. Portia, I did, my lord. So she said, yes, my lord. Dr. Valerio has sent me. Duke, you are welcome. Take your place. Are you acquainted with the difference that holds this present question in the court? So Duke says, you are welcome, and then says that, are you aware of what is the matter? Are you acquainted of the dispute that is here, that is going on, that is involved in the present case before the court? Portia, I am informed thoroughly of the cause, which is the merchant here and which is the Jew. So she says, yes, I know what the matter is. And then she asks, who is the merchant and who is the Jew? Means she is asking, who is Antonio? Because she has never seen Antonio and Shylock in her life. So she does not know who is Antonio and who is Jew. So she is asking, yes, I know what the matter is. Tell me, who is the merchant and who is the Jew? Duke, Antonio and old Shylock both stand for Portia. Is your name Shylock? Shylock. Shylock is my name. So Duke says, Antonio and Shylock both are standing right in front of you. So Portia asks Shylock, is your name Shylock? So Shylock says, yes, my name is Shylock. Portia, of a strange nature is the suit you follow, yet in such rule that the Vietnam law cannot impugn you. As you do proceed, you stand within his danger, do you not? So he's saying, Portia is saying that the case that you have brought here, is quite strange in nature. And yet, and then also, you are standing here seeking for judgment. Do you realize that you are taking the penalties from Antonio, which are harmful for his life also? If you cut 1 pound of flesh from his body, obviously you are posing an harm towards his life. Antonio, So Antonio is saying, yes, I know all these things, because he says that he wants to take away my life. Portia, do you confess the bond? Antonio, I do. Portia, then must the Jew be merciful? Shylock, on what compulsion must I tell me that? So Antonio, Portia is asking Antonio, do you agree that you signed this bond? So Antonio says, yes, I was the one who signed this bond. So Portia said, then Jew, you should be a little merciful. Yes, he signed the bond, but you should not take away his life. You can think of some other solution to the problem that you people are facing, but you should not take away his life. You can find out some other solution. So Shylock is saying, on what compulsion? Why are you people compelling me? Why are you people pressurizing me to, take revenge from him, not to fulfill my bond? Okay. Portia, the quality of mercy is not strained. It drop in as gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It is twice blessed. It is blessed him that gives and him that takes. So Portia is still trying to persuade this man, and Portia is saying that mercy is a blessing that comes from heaven, and it becomes twice for the person who shows mercy towards the others. Right, the person who is merciful towards the others is blessed. Okay, he is shown mercy from the heaven. This mightest in the mightest, it is the most powerful. And when it comes to talking about power, this is the most powerful thing in the world. It becomes the throned monarch better than his crown. The king that is sitting, he becomes more powerful if he is merciful. His scepter shows force of temporal power, the attribute to awe and majesty, wherein doth sit the dread and fear of kings. But mercy is above the sceptred sway. It is enthroned in the hearts of kings. It is an attribute to God himself, and earthly power doth then show likest gods when mercy seasons justice. So Portia is saying that mercy, I am just trying to explain you things, because you know mercy makes the monarch more powerful. If people are afraid of crown and everything, but when it comes to mercy, it doubles your power, it doubles everything. These people start fearing people who are merciful. Okay, and it is an attribute, it is an attitude which comes from God. Okay, and mercy, when justice is just when it comes to justice, mercy should be shown. Therefore, Jew, through justice, by thy plea, be thy plea, consider this, that in the course of justice, none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy, and that same prayer doth teach us all to render the deeds of mercy. So again, Portia is saying that you are seeking justice, I know. You take the justice, that is okay. But just keep in mind that when you claim for this justice, no harm should be shown to anybody. Remember that it should be a strict justice by God. You should not take justice. You should not take revenge. Let God do whatever. In the prayer also, we always say, Christian prayer, we always say, forgive those who trespass against us. Okay, as we forgive our sins, as we forgive those who trespass, those who sin against us. Jo hamare khilaf, something is done by somebody, forgive that person. We pray to God. So he's, Portia is saying that in the prayers also, we always say we pray for mercy. Okay, I have spoken thus much to mitigate the justice of thy plea, which if you follow this court of Venice, must needs give sentence against the merchant there. So he's saying, Portia is saying that I have spoken much. I don't want to speak anything more. You should keep in mind when you are taking the justice, when you are taking the revenge, you should keep in mind all these things and you should not, do anything against this merchant present in the court. Okay. Shylock. Yes, my deeds upon my head. I crave the law, the penalty and forfeit of my bond. So Shylock is a very stubborn man. He's saying whatever wrong I am doing, that will come upon my head. I do not have any problem. Whatever things I am doing, I take the responsibility of those things. But I want the justice and I want the agreement to be followed. Okay? Okay?
Yes,
ma'am. So we stop here, children. I don't want you to burden your minds. I just want you all to revise what we have done today. Quickly, Avi will do it. Quickly, Avi, in your own words, kindly tell us what we just did right now in the class. You need not read anything from the book. You need not quote anything. You just have to tell what has happened now, right now.
We have discussed about the talks of Antonio Bassanio, Antonio and his friends, and Shylock. Ma'am, in which Antonio's friends were saying Shylock to forgive and just be merciful towards Antonio. And ma'am, Antonio was very sad. Ma'am, after that, Portia came in the form of Dr. Balthazar and fights for
in the form, in disguise of
Dr. Balthazar and fights for Antonio.
She has not yet started fighting for Antonio. She's still trying to persuade this man so that he can show some mercy.
Yes.
Smriti, what has happened in the scene? From the start, you have to tell me. Yesterday, what we did, and today, what we did, the entire story I want from you. Quickly.
Ma'am,
tell me from the starting that there be that this scene takes place in a courtroom and all these things. Tell me from the start better.
Ma'am, this scene take place in Venice, a court of justice. Ma'am, in this scene.
Quickly, Smriti.
In this scene, there are Duke, Antonio, Shylock, Arias, and Duke.
What are they doing here?
Ma'am, the Shylock is saying ki, I do not take money. I want to take 1 pound of flesh of Antonio's body.
Okay. So what does Antonio say about it?
Antonio said ki you take 6 ducats, 3 ducats from
this Antonio me. Says, but, Smriti, this is said by Antonio. Arunesh, who says, who offers him 6,000 ducats?
Bassanio.
Bassanio offers him, Smriti. Bassanio offers 6,000 ducats to Shylock and says that you take double the money and leave Antonio. Then what happens, Smriti?
Ma'am, Shylock say ki no, I didn't want to take money. I want to take 1 pound of flesh.
I don't and, want to take money. Hmm.
And ma'am, Shylock say the Lord that ki
stop using key, Smriti. What happens then?
Ma'am, Shylock is saying ki ma'am.
That he will take
revenge.
Okay.
1 pound of flesh.
Revenge. Okay. Revenge is also okay. Okay. Then what happens?
Ma'am. Then the ma'am when Duke bring the letter. Ma'am when Duke bring the letter. So then, Ma'am Narissa dressed like a lawyer, and say, and then Duke say, you come from Padua.
Okay, stop and here. Arunesh, continue.
Narissa and Portia come in disguise of lawyers, and right. Narissa was the lawyer's clerk.
Right.
And the Duke asked Portia, or disguised as Lord Balthazar, that you come from Padua, from the lawyer.
Then
she says yes, and then Duke asks her that she, if she knows about the case or not, details about the case or not. And she says that she knows, but she doesn't know who the Antonio and Shylock is. So she asks, so the Duke says that they both are standing in front of you. So okay. She first asks Shylock that, are you Shylock? Then Shylock says that I am Shylock.
Right. Then what happens? What is the event that takes place next?
And she also tries to persuade Shylock.
Yes.
To forgive.
Antonio. What does she say? What does she say to Shylock? What quality is she referring to? What is she saying? That what should he be?
Merciful.
He should be. Should be merciful. So that when there is anything, anything against him, mercy can also be shown towards Shylock. Okay. So we have stopped here. We will continue with it tomorrow. Okay, children, keep filling the workbook, because after finishing off, I will be discussing the workbook with you. Okay, bye everybody. Have a very good day. Enjoy.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.